self-driving car test in 3, 2, 1.
Now, I can't drive, but I really want to be able to drive a car to my destination instead of biking all the way there. I live in the Netherlands, I bike a lot. Luckily, for the past few decades, self-driving cars have become a much larger thing in the world. The development of these cars has been going on since the 1920s, which has been almost a century. There's just one problem. I'm not allowed to drive these things, and I don't have near enough money to buy one. So I made my own level 3 self-driving car in a bit more than 1 month. So the way this works is that there are 6 levels of autonomy in vehicles, with level 0 being no automation and level 5 being full autonomy. The furthest humans have come is level 3, with level 4 being debatable. In terms of Lego, I've only seen people build self-guided Lego vehicles using magnets or hidden tracks, or the basic stop once you see a wall and drive in a different direction. I consider these things to be at autonomy level 1. Driver assistance. And although these vehicles are pretty amazing on their own, I figured why not skip level 2 and go right to the highest level of autonomy people have been able to make so far. Here's what the car needs to be able to do. It needs to be able to control both steering and speed autonomously, it needs to be able to do this under normal environmental conditions, and it needs to do all this with just me providing the driver's oversight. I'm not actually driving it, but I mean I made it, so technically I'm the one responsible for its driving. Finally, I'm going to test these things in the final ultimate test. Now, let me tell you a bit about how this car is going to achieve these things. It uses 6 sensors to determine whether or not it's approaching any obstacles or is going to crash into something. There are 2 infrared sensors in the front that can turn 90 degrees for optimal coverage of the front area. There's 1 ultrasonic sensor in the back that can look 30 degrees to both sides. Under the hood, there's a gyroscope that can tell in which direction the car is heading. Finally, there are 2 light sensors that can sense if the car has passed objects and can continue in its original direction. It uses 5 motors to, of course, control the speed and steering and turn the sensors from left to right. Oh, and it's got some storage space, which is nice, I guess. Once it approaches an object that it can drive past, it's going to steer more and more to the clear side as it's getting closer till it passes the object. If it's getting too close without passing, it's going to stop and drive back a bit and steer a bit more to the clear side. While passing the object, it's constantly checking whether or not it passed the object. Once it has passed the object, it steers itself back to the direction it was heading. Once it approaches an object that it can't drive past, it's going to look for a way out to its left and right side. If it can go left or right, it will. If it can't go left or right, it's going to drive backwards till it can't go any further and then continues to drive forward. Finally, once it approaches an object that's moving, it's going to wait till it moves along and isn't in the way anymore. For the rest of the occasions, it's just going to drive endlessly. Whew, okay, now that's out of the way, the ultimate driving test will look like this.
Oh, I didn't tell you this, but it's also going to auto park in this particular spot. Okay. Let's not wait any longer and test this thing. Self-driving car test in 3, 2, 1.
As you can see, the car perfectly passed all the stages of the test without crashing once. Almost. Yeah, I had to redo the entire thing after that moment, but it managed to complete the entire course the second time without crashing. Or actually twice, because I had to get myself some more footage. Now you know why I'm still a level 3 and all the other existing self-driving cars are as well. Occasionally, things just go wrong, as for example, a camera or sensor could just not pick up a small obstacle. Or net our desk. Now, if you're like me and can't drive, or if you're nothing like me and can drive, or if you simply just enjoyed this video,
no way you don't fall into at least one of these categories,
then make sure you leave a like and tell me in the comment section what you want me to build next. You may as well check out this video where I built my own Lego 3D printer that can print out 3D models.
No way you don't fall into at least one of these categories, huh?
Whoa.